let's talk about some common warnings that we might see. The first is regarding reviews. So there are two different review fields that can be used, and both of these are optional. You should expect to see warnings for both the review and aggregate rating if you have no reviews on your product. Review companies don't always provide the structured data needed to qualify for search enhancements. Maybe that's because it's on a higher tier of their product offering, or they just don't know that it should be provided. But usually when a review provider does include the structured data for reviews, it's separate from the rest of your product data. And when they're separate pieces of information, you usually can get reviews or price and availability, but rarely all three of those, which you should be able to get. And that's one of the reasons why our app, JSON-LD for SEO, integrates with over 20 review providers. Now, if you have reviews, only the aggregate rating should be used. So you will still see that review field warning. The review field doesn't apply to Shopify products. It's for a critic review, which is where someone writes an article about maybe a business or a book or a movie. I want to expand on that a little bit. Let's say you send one of your products to an influencer to write up an unbiased review. So they write up a review on their website about your product, and they say it's 4.5 stars as shown in this result for the 7 best shower tile cleaners of 2022. That is a critic review. For product reviews, you should only use aggregate rating. The aggregate rating gathers all of the reviews for a particular product on your site, aggregates the ratings, and comes up with one final review rating. The risk of using the review field is that Google may show the reviewer's name and only show their rating instead of the aggregate of all of the reviews for that product.